you can go into smaller things to see. This is basically what we want to see. We are not happy what we see with our eyes. We edit our eyes with binocular other things. Then comes the microscope, and then the electron microscope, scanning electron microscope, turning the electron microscope. No, but that's not enough. We are going further down, okay, in order to see further into the nature. If you look at the money, this is what I said, money is more. The amount of money is, you can see, is $3,680 million per year. So it's about $4 billion business per year. This is how people are interested in studying accelerator physics. Okay? But the thing is, if there's so much money, the guy who said that I will spend less money and I will do the experiment here at CUS, and this should be the guy I will be, you know, employed here at CUS. So if you want to go for this one, you need to come up with an idea to say enough is enough. We cannot really afford to have 100 kilometers. We cannot afford to have 30 kilometers. We cannot afford even to have 10 meter long. We want to have something inside our own building. This is what we are looking for. This is where the idea of a laser wake-field accelerator is. So, interest in the alternative methods for various limitations is technological is one. Financial is the biggest one. Accessibility is also another one. And management is the fourth one that I consider to be important. Technological is not that we cannot really have a machine. There is another problem. The superconducting RF cavity that I said was a novel thing, and people were very happy about that one. If you increase the voltage in space, what happens? You have two plates, you start increasing, let's say 100 volt, 200 volt, 300 volt, 400 volt, what will happen? Yes? You will have ionization, right? Okay, so if you are unwalking, perhaps you say, no ionization, but no. RF is the radio frequency, so it will move inside metals. And if you increase the voltage, you will have the breakdown of the material. And this is where it becomes dangerous, because the gradient of electric field that one can afford inside the RF cavity is not enough to have energy of the sort of 30 tera electron volt or 50 tera electron volt in even in 100 kilometer long machine, or even in 80 kilometer long cyclotron. And this is the reason. Financial, of course, if you think that, okay, you're putting some more machines together, but of course this is very expensive, you have to put in a lot of money. Accessibility is that it's not really accessible to everybody. We in Pakistan perhaps do not have the access. Not many of us will have access to utilize such facilities until and unless we are part of the collaboration. Pakistan is part of one small collaboration, which is with the LHC. LHC is not giving full access to the extent of utilizing and getting data, but they are giving us data in forms of computational data available on the net, and our students normally would just, you know, download the data and use some software to get some results out of it. Still quite good, of course. And management is also a problem. If you have a machine which is 100 kilometers long, anything happen on one side, the other side, you need to have some time, the people, to understand what is happening. So you cannot have meetings every day, and that will be a really wastage of time. So this is also a problem. So this is why we talked about a laser acceleration of the electrons. These basic optics, if you have a lens, and you have beam coming in of diameter D, this will be focused around the Z direction in such a form. This perhaps you have seen at the F is the focal length of the lens, and the focus spot will have a diameter of 1.22 F lambda divided by D, depending on the wavelength of the laser that you are using. And it will have a certain range. During that range, you can see that the focus part could be considered as uniform. It's just a half reduction in the intensity. So the intensity of a laser beam could be defined in terms of the energy divided by the area of the spot divided by the pulse length of the laser that you have. So if you consider, if you have an energy of 5 joule and you have a pulse length of 30 femtoseconds, and the square diameter these days, the optics is quite good. You can focus it to even to 1 micron. But let's say you have a focus part of 10 micrometer, and you put these values in there, then you can see that the intensity is gigantic. It's 10 power 20 watt per centimeter square. So it's a huge intensity. The intensity of the sun on the earth is minuscule as compared to this intensity. Perhaps you have observed, I always share this story. When we were students at school, this was fun for us when we were primary school kids, that we were carrying a small lens in our pocket. And because we would not have proper rooms in our school, we would be sitting outside somewhere, either underneath a tree or something. And then there would be some sunlight coming in, then we would, you know, just pick the lens and focus the sunlight on the back shirt of the fellow sitting in front of us. And we'll try to burn the shirt of that fellow. So this is the important thing that you do, that you can increase the intensity. Otherwise, it's not really so much if you have much energy. Energy from the sun is too much, but the intensity is not so much on the surface of the earth. Yes, please.
Pulse is a physical quantity.
Yes.
Mentioned there.
Yes, pulse is a physical quantity. Yeah. You can have a collection of, if you think in terms of photon to see, because we would not be able to see, a collection of photons, the width of the collection of photons will be the pulse length. And of course, this is just to confuse some of those who were not listening to us when we were teaching electromagnetism, that there is something called Poynting vector. Poynting vector is the cross product of the electric field and the magnetic field. And this could be related to the electric field, the total intensity. And the total intensity here coming out to be 10 power 20. And if you put 10 power 20 in there, 10 power 20 will give you another zero coming out. So you will have 30 multiplied by 10 will be 300 giga electron volt per centimeter. This is 1,000 times greater than what a RF cavity can afford. So radio frequency can afford about a few tens of giga electron volt. This is 300 giga electron volt. So it's huge gradient that you can have. So good, because if you have so much of energy, so much of intensity, so much electric field, one would think, aha, we have electric field of laser, why not utilize it? We will be able to accelerate the particles to such a great extent. Because remember, force is equal to Q into E. So all you have to do is multiply the charge on electron with this electric field, which is 300. So in 1 meter, in 1 centimeter even, in 1 centimeter, you will be able to accelerate the object to something close to the velocity of light. So it seems quite nice, right? Okay. But there is a problem, but let me tell you something else, that how do we get such high intensity? This is owing to these two guys, Donna and Gerard. They have published this paper, by the way, in Optics Communication, but perhaps one of the papers which has got the highest citation. This guy Gerard Moreau was telling us the story that they sent this paper to Physical Review letter. It was rejected, and they said no, this idea would not work. But this student was stubborn enough. It was not like a Pakistani student when they say, okay, my supervisor say don't do it, okay, you don't do it. She sent it by herself to Optics Communication, and then from that day onward, the whole thing just started, and people started using this idea. And this guy is now, he got the Schwalbe Prize, in fact, for this idea. He is the boss. He was the poor, she was the poor student. So student didn't get anything, but the boss got it. So how does it work? You have an oscillator. Oscillator is basically the initial stage of a laser, where you have a small amount of energy coming out of the machine. It is also in the form of a laser, but we don't call it a complete laser. So it will have a short pulse. A short pulse will come, but the problem with short pulse is the intensity is very high. Remember, the intensity is inversely proportional to the duration of the pulse. Okay, so the shorter the pulse, the higher the intensity. So that means you cannot really amplify this further. It will be too difficult to amplify because it's already having high intensity. High intensity means you can have a dynamic threshold crossed already. And it will block all the optics in the way. So you cannot make it higher intensity. So then what you do is you stretch it. The stretching will be because we'll have different colors will have different you have different colors going in different delay, and then you put them together, and then you put this through amplifier. Now the pulse length is long, is a nanosecond. Instead of femtosecond, is now a nanosecond. Now you have the possibility to increase the intensity. So you increase the energy through amplifier, the stretch amplifier pulse now. This pulse is again compressed again. So you do the reverse process. Whatever is done here is now reversed again. So you get a pulse now which is amplified and it's a very short pulse. So this is how this idea was, that you can produce these femtosecond pulses for this one. And you can see, if you look at the evolution around here, we're only talking about the intensity which is crossing 10 power 23. The early project is aimed at 10 power 25. This is the project coming up to have the intensity 10 power 25 so that you can go into the walking polarization. These are the ultra-relativistic regime that you would like to have. So the energy these days in laser is in tens of megajoules and nanosecond, and or in tens of joules and femtoseconds. So very high efficiency lasers are available these days. This energy looks big, megajoules, but I shared the chocolate cake with you before. I'm not sharing the chocolate cake, but the picture. Those of you who are diet conscious, this chocolate could be around 500 kilocalories. 4 calories is with a big C. This is kilocalories, okay?